Hey guys! Welcome to one of our Ninja Monkey tutorials. My name is Yeknam and next to me sits Ajnan.
Hey guys!
We are the Ninja Monkeys from ekvip. Today we want to show you how you can load a PLC project on the PLC and start it. Later we will also explain how to update the PLC project on the PLC and how you can deal with differences between the project in the IDE and the project on the target. We start with a really simple example.
We create a new PLC project. We select the standard PLC project and give it a name. Now the tree in our Solution Explorer has changed. Under POUs, which stands for Program Organization Units, we find our main program, which was created by default when we set up our PLC project. We will come back to the POUs in detail in one of our next videos. If we click on the PLC task, we find the main program again, because it's linked to the task. This task was also created by default when we set up our PLC project. The program linked to the task is executed with the preset cycle time. For our example, we will use the main program. Click on it. The editor window opens. Here we can edit the source code of the program in structured text.
In some of our next videos, we will go more into detail with this topic and explain structured text.
The upper part of the editor is the declaration part. Here you can declare variables and objects which are used in the program. Beneath it is the implementation part. Here you implement the algorithm which is processed in the main program. As said before, we will work with a simple example, therefore we just declare one variable. We write its name between var and var. Let's name it counter1, because it will be a counter. Behind the variable, we indicate the type of the variable and end the line with a semicolon. As type we choose dint. Dint stand for double integer. We also will explain more about variables and their types in a further video. Now we go to the implementation part and use our declared variable. Our counter1 should be counter1 plus 2. That's it for now.
It's always a good idea to build your project before downloading it. This will tell you if you have, for example, any syntax errors or misspelled variable names. You can either right-click on the PLC project and choose Build, or you click in the menu bar on Build and select Build Solution. Note that you can either make a build for the whole solution or for a selected PLC project. During the build, our PLC project gets compiled. After compiling, you can check the message window. This line tells you if there are any errors. It should say 1 succeeded and 0 failed. If it failed, take a look at the error messages in the output messages. If you double-click on it, it should bring you to the site of the error or close to it. It also makes sense to clean the solution before the build. If you clean the solution before building it, all unnecessary, temporary files will be deleted. Means the local compilation information for the currently active projects are deleted and the command updates the language model of all objects. If you never clean your solution, the project can become really huge over time. And that means the folder for the PLC as well. There is another command. It's the rebuild solution command. More or less, it is one command for cleaning and building the solution. It first cleans and then builds the solution.
After we did this, we can activate the configuration. Yes, we want to restart TwinCAT in run mode. Now our login button appears. Click on it. This downloads the code and configuration via ADS to the PLC. After the login, we are able to do online debugging. We can watch all variables and their data, and the data can be changed by us. This question appears because we did not enable the autoboot feature. We select yes. Now we are able to start. We need to click on the green start command. If you want to stop, click on the red stop command. For logging out, we need to click on this command.
Now we want to show you what's going to happen if we do a change in our program. We declare a new variable. We call it counter 2. We implement it. Now we build the solution to check if the program is error-free. We log in again. Now a new window appears. TwinCAT recognized that the application has changed and asked us what we want to do. Before we explain the different options and decide what we want to do, we want to show you a little feature. Click on the Details button. Here you can see the changes in the source code since the last download. This overview is very rudimentary. If you want to see what in detail changed, close the window. Go to the Solution Explorer, right-click on the PLC project and select Compare with the Target System now. The changed parts in the project are highlighted. Here you can see the changes in the program in detail.
Now let's get back to the previous situation. We made the changes and now TwinCAT asks us how we want to continue with them. There are three ways how we can transfer the modified project. Online change. Download. Or login without any changes. The last option is clear, but what are the differences between the other two options? During an online change, a running program is not stopped. Only the modified parts are reloaded into the controller. You could use these options if you did some minor modification of the project. If you did a lot of modification, this can cause troubles because the program behavior cannot be predicted reliably. If you did a lot of changes, we recommend selecting login with download. If we download the changes, the program will be stopped. A download leads to a new compilation. This option of data transfer is recommended by Beckhoff, since it always leads to a defined output state as a result of the program stop and the reinitialization.
That's it for today. We hope to see you again on our channel.
If you are interested in TwinCAT-related stuff, check out our other videos and subscribe to our channel. If you want to see where we work and what our colleagues do, you can visit the ekvip website. Have a nice day.
Yeah, enjoy your day. Bye-bye.
Bye.